The following are excerpts from a conversation between Mr. Peter Kelly and Elmer Strong, tape recorded at Matawatchan in July of 1965.
Go back then to the first people in Matawatchan.
Well, I couldn't tell you in what year, but they were in before my grandfather, anyway. The McLennans, and there used to be a bunch of Frasers here.
Frasers?
Yes, Frasers owned that place where Billy McLean is.
Oh?
And where McLeod is. He's covered the old man, Fraser, and then Jim Fraser, and Jim was only a little boy. They came up the Madawaska, and then they came up the Colton Creek. And right where the line joins between Strong and Hunter down at the Colton Creek, they camped between at a big pine cedar.
Uh-huh.
The Travis was the biggest cedar in Ontario.
Is that right? This is the corner of the Madawaska and the... the Colton Creek, the corner of...
Strong St. Hunter's Creek.
Hunter's Creek,
where they joined down there. But what year that was, I couldn't tell you, but I know it was before.
I heard
they were away from here when my grandfather came. You see, Dawson kept store there at McLeod's.
Well,
after Fraser was
after there. Fraser. Did Fraser come in here? Was it timber rights that he had here?
No, he just came in for to farm, and the timber as far as labor was concerned.
Yeah.
They weren't lumbermen.
Uh-huh.
No, they just came in. That's what took my grandfather here from Glengarry. It was the same cry there for years. They were looking for the railroad and no railroad coming. They lived in a place called Lochale, Glengarry County.
Lochale?
Yeah.
Glengarry.
Yeah. And they looked, and their land was a free grant from the old country.
Oh?
They never could sell it.
Was this in Glengarry?
Yes, it went from there to the successor, the oldest son.
Yeah. Do you know where they came from in Scotland?
My grandfather, on my mother's side, they came from, and my grandfather on my mother's side too, they came from Edinburgh.
From Edinburgh?
Scotland.
And they had a free grant in Glengarry?
Yes, and
this is probably it's for military service or something?
I know it was encouraged settlers, you know, to come.
Yeah.
There was very few here at that time.
Yeah.
And, but when they came to Matawatchan, and they heard about the timber up here and the big lumbermen, so they came up thinking they'd get lots of work anyway. And they left the farm. And 2 years, 3 years after, I guess it was, 3 years after, you see, the place would fall to my Uncle Angus. He was the oldest.
Mm-hmm.
And him and Uncle Dan went back 3 years after, and they couldn't get ahead of him. They just sold some taxes, and the railroad went right through the orchard.
Right through the
orchard. Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
So they never did recover that?
No, they never got nothing for it. I guess it was sold for taxes.
Yeah.
And,
well, quite a number of people came up from Glengarry here. The Kellys and the Thompsons, the McPhersons, is that right?
No, the Kellys, they came from... my grandfather came from the north of Ireland, on my father's side. And he said that he never knew of any of his farm. There's a lot of Kellys came over here.
Mm-hmm.
But he said he never knew if any of his relations came over. He had one brother, he said that he knew he went to Australia.
Mm-hmm.
But where the rest went, he doesn't know anything about them. And then my grandmother, my father's mother, she came from the south of Ireland, from, what do you call the capital?
Dublin.
And there's Dublin County, you see.
Uh-huh.
That's where she came from. But there was an awful lot of them. She had one sister came with her and five brothers. And they made a lot on that side, but there was none on the Kelly side that they ever knew that was related to us.
Where did they settle when they originally came over?
and he settles it at the mountain.
At Mountain Battery?
Yes.
Okay.
Well, then my grandfather comes, you know where Tommy Haley lives?
Vaguely I do, yeah, I'm not.
Well, that was my grandfather's farm.
Is that right?
After he got settled around, he took that up and he farmed. And that's where my father was, all the family was born.
What was your grandfather's first name?
Edward.
Edward.
Yeah. Yeah. And my grandmother's name was Margaret Ann. Maggie Ann. Maggie Ann O'Hare. That's the McLennans was in here before that. And the year that my grandfather come here, that was the year that Dave McLennan was drowned.
Oh?
On Mackie Creek.
What, on a log ride with him?
Yes, and he was the first one that went in that graveyard.
Over here?
Yeah.
Is
that, yeah, there was a big elm tree there at that time. He was buried right beside the elm tree. He was the first one who went in the graveyard. Dave McLennan in 1859.
1859.
Yes.
A long time ago.
Yes.
Soon be 100 years.
Yes.
Well, was he, Dave McLennan, he was
it's
the guy.
Over 100
years. Yeah, it is, too.
Oh, yeah, it is.
Yeah,
well,
it's 106 years, I guess.
Yeah.
Yep. Yes, McLennan's was in here. It seems to me McLennan's, they had a little money when they came here. They seemed to be a little better fixed than the rest, you know. They were pretty poor, just little shanties. But they had kind of put up a fairly nice house, you know. They had a little money. And when the preachers, there was a few Catholics around, and when the priest had come about once a month, or maybe every 2 months, and hold a service, in the school or in the houses.
Mm-hmm.
But then nobody could keep them overnight. There had no place to get them. And they used to stay at McLennan's. But they wanted to pay her, but she wouldn't take it. No, no, she said, never take money from travelers. But it went on, and this time they wanted to pay her again, and then she wouldn't take it. And she said, and the priest said, well, you're a fine woman, Mrs. McLennan. He said, since we're talking, what do you think of us people? Well, she says, she was very broad. Since you asked me, I'll tell you. If there's one place in hell harder than another, that's where you should be.
These original people, they came up, the McLennans.
They all come from Scotland.
Came from Scotland.
Yeah. Old Mrs. McLennan. After the old man was dead long ago then, and it was just Hester there with her granddaughter.
Mm-hmm.
And she used to get my brother Hugh and I to hoe corn for the 80s. And up above the house in the corner of the fence was a big pine stump there.
Mm-hmm.
And about 9, 10 o'clock, the old lady would get up. And she'd have her staff, and she'd go up past us, up to that stump.
In the daytime?
Oh, yeah. And she'd talk away in Gaelic. Gaelic, I guess, right? Mm-hmm. And she'd be pounding at the stump. And then she'd start, down with the witches, down with the witches. And she'd pound the stump. Well, she was frightened the life out of Joey and I. We wouldn't stay there at night. And when we get her supper, we'd beat it up, and, up in the crowd. With Matt and Abe. Yeah. But
she was a wee bit superstitious, I guess.
Yeah. I don't know. A bunch of them that came from Scotland, old Mrs. McDonald up there was the same. She'd be wandering away and talking to the witches.
Is this Mrs. Archie McDonald? Or?
Mrs. Billy.
Billy McDonald.
Yeah. It was Archie and Bill. Yeah, there was quite a lot of them. I think in Scotland around them. Bill Thompson's up there. They came from Scotland, and What was her agreement? Mrs. Bill Thompson and Mrs. McGregor used to be up here. They were sisters. They came from Scotland, too.
Oh?
Me. But quite a while before I remember.
So this primarily was a Scottish settlement then?
Yes. Oh, yes, at one time. My uncle John Thompson, he came from Scotland, too, but from a different part, and he wasn't related to these other Thompsons at all.
I see.
One spells her name C-H-U-M-P-S, and one the other is C-H-U-M-S.
I see.
It's
a different family altogether.
Yes. Yeah.
And, really should be pronounced Thompson.
I remember I had the two Davy Thompsons on the road here one time. This Quinton was brother of Charles Quinton. He was engineer. And he gave me a little job for on some gravel. And when we went to settle up, I had the two Davy Thompsons on. What's the reason what this? Said that man, you have that man on twice. Well, I said, look, one spells her name T-H-U-M-S-O-N, the other T-H-U-M-P-S-O-N. Well, I said, what made the difference? Well, I said, I'll tell you what made the difference. I said, one comes from Irish Scotland, and the other from Northern Scotland. And a different way of spelling his name. And for the time, well, he wouldn't settle, so I had to go and get the two babies and bring them together.
Is that right?
Yeah. Oh, there was a lot of men, and they made potash in here. They used to make the potash, one of them maple. It's when you know
well, I've heard about this. And
yeah. That's where that name goes, the potash.
The potash kettle over here.
Potash corner there.
Yeah.
That's how we got his name. That's where we used to burn the maple and leach the ashes and make the potash. Barrel it up and chip it.
Was this the farmers when they were clearing their land?
Yes.
Or did they make business of this?
Well, most of the farmers was at it. You remember that you've seen the big potash kettles?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
There was a lot of them. I guess every farmer had one.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And I often had my mother send money, and they stayed up all night. Burning maple to get the ashes.
This would be sort of a cash crop for them, though.
Yes, yes, about the only thing they do. And they used to make their, they had no coal at that time.
Mm-hmm.
All they had was the charcoal out of there. There was two charcoal pits here. There's one right up near our old place there. It's just like a great big pit. And they put the wood in there, the maple in there, and burn it and burn it. And when it gets all in cold, then they take it out. And they used to bag that and ship it. And that's all they had for the blacksmith shop.
For the blacksmith shop?
Yeah. Charcoal. I can show you the old pit. There was one over in this corner somewhere, but I don't know just where. But I know I heard them saying about two.
Any idea what... how much money they'd get for that potash when they'd sell it? Mostly they'd sell it in one of these wooden drums or barrels, they
yes,
know, the staves.
The coal, I think they shipped it in bags. Jute bags. But the potash, it went in bags.
Yeah.
And the square timber. And the great run for square timber.
I guess there was a lot of that up in this area here.
Yeah.
Who took that out? Do you remember who the
was? Well, the ones at that time. Mackay was one of the old ones. And Batson.
Batson.
And Caldwell.
Caldwell.
Yeah. There was a Caldwell in the hospital with me this spring in Blackwell there. He comes from Caldwell Station. It was after them that that's got the name. And I asked him, was he any relation to these old Caldwell that you used to remember? And he said, well, I don't know. He said, if I was, he said, they never left me a cent.
Thank you. speckled bird. Remember, her name is recorded on the pages of God's holy word. With all the other birds flocking round her, by the squaw. The great speckled bird is the Bible, representing the great church of God, desiring to lower her standard. They watch every move that she made. They long to find fault with her teaching, but really they find no mistake. I am glad I have learned of her meekness. I am proud that my name on her book, for I want to be one never fearing the face of my Savior's true love. When he cometh descending from heaven on the clouds as he rides in his word, I'll be joyfully carried to meet him on the wings of that great speckled bird.
Hi. The date is February 2022. I'm Brian Kelly, Peter's grandson. Just wanted to say how I enjoyed putting this video together with the interview of Grandpa by Elmer Strong, and to hear his voice, it brought back many memories of Matawatchan. I would also like to say how great it was of Elmer to interview not only my grandfather, but so many more older folks as well. You can listen to them by going to www.matawaskahighlander.ca and check out Heritage Recordings. I went to live with my Kelly grandparents in 1944 when my mother, Isabella Hudson, passed away. I was less than 2 years old at the time. I lived with them until I was 17, and my sister Isabella, aka Debbie, and I went to Whitehorse with our dad, Clifton, and stepmother Fran in 1959. I always say how lucky I was to have such great grandparents on both sides of the family, and they lived in Matawatchan all their lives. Regarding the photos, I would like to explain about the growth on Grandpa Kelly's neck. That started in his early 30s. It was always referred to as a goiter, but not sure at the time, and they just left it alone. In his later years, he found out it was a cyst. And in 1970, when he was 83, it started to drain and completely went away on its own. He said it never hurt him, but he put up with the damn thing most of his life. Hope all enjoyed the video and the old photos. Now I'm going to be 80 this summer. How the old time flies by. Cheers, Brian.